Hey, welcome along everyone. Happy Valentine's. Hope you're having a nice day. Whatever you're doing with your loved ones, whoever they are, if there's your partner or your family or however you want to spend your Valentine's Day, Yeah, I've got my a biscuit here, which was very kindly given to me by my daughter, who has just received it from her boyfriend. So I might actually eat that later in the session. Thanks to everyone who's been getting involved in the Discord this week. It's really nice to see it growing now. And also a massive shout to NKG. I did a little kind of shout out this week earlier, and I said, has anyone got any suggestions for something to do for Valentine's Day? I was actually planning something completely different, and then I suddenly remembered, oh yeah, it's Valentine's Day, so be good to do something. So NKG came up with the suggestion of this track remixed by Matthew Herbert. I've got the record here. Is that the right way? No, there we go. And it's Bonnie and Clyde, the classic track by Serge Gainsbourg and Brigitte Bardot. And yeah, it came out on this album, this compilation album in 2001. Some fantastic remixes on it. It's got Dax Riders, Bob Sinclair, Demon Richie, Phase Action. Big shout out to Rob, how you doing? Herbert, of course, and The Orb as well. So if you can pick that up, I thoroughly recommend it. It's got a really nice cover. I did a little Photoshop actually of the badge, I Love Serge. So let's just see what's going on. If you want to kind of ask any questions that are going on, with these sessions, I'm tending not really to do any preparation on purpose. Bit different to the kind of normal deconstructions that I've done on for Point Blank and that kind of thing, where I generally do quite a lot of preparation and practice to kind of get it perfect. This is like kind of starting from scratch almost. I've done some very basic preparation, but it's pretty much starting from scratch. Let's get going. So what I've got, I think maybe if we listen to the original version first, have a listen through all the way through, and then we'll listen to the remix. And then we'll just start looking at the elements in Ableton Live and start kind of trying to piece it together, if possible. Big shout out to Matthew Herbert as well, who's liked a couple of the posts in the last couple of days. Thank you very much. Just to make clear, this is not my remix. This is Matthew Herbert's remix. So cool. Let's have a listen to the original version. This is Serge Gainsbourg and Brigitte Bardot. And this actually came out in 1968, so quite a while ago. Nice to have you along. Great, so that's the track. It was going a bit out of sync actually, because I kind of ripped the video and put it along to the audio track, and it's just going a bit out, but it didn't really matter. That is really fantastic, isn't it? And I'm just going to read actually a little excerpt from the research I did from it. So Bonnie and Clyde is a French language song written by Serge Gainsbourg and performed by Gainsbourg and Brigitte Bardot, who I believe he was dating at the time. The song tells the story of the outlaw couple Bonnie and Clyde. It's based on an English language poem written by Bonnie Parker herself a few weeks before she and Clyde Barrow were shot, entitled The Trail's End. It was released on two albums in 1968, Gainsbourg's album Initials BB and Gainsbourg and Bardot's album Bonnie and Clyde. So you can check it out, that, and I believe it was a pretty big hit as well. So before I play the Herbert remix, I have actually managed to extract the a cappella of this. It didn't come out that well, unfortunately, but still it's better than nothing. And I used the Neural Mix Pro software that I think I showed last week, which I absolutely love. I have to say, it's so good. I mean, I know that it's probably using kind of a splitter algorithm or whatever, but it's really nice. So let me just kind of quickly play you a bit of that, just so you can hear what we're going to be working with.
Vous avez lu l'histoire de Jesse James? Comment il vécu? Comment il est mort?
So it's not bad. what I love, it's just such a great feature of this track, is this little kind of, I don't know if I can do it myself, the kind of no, I can't do it. That. And actually you'll hear that Matthew Herbert makes a feature of that. So there is the original. Let's now have a listen to the remix. And yeah, I've got this on vinyl and I've recorded myself. I recorded a video of the recording into the computer, which is a bit nerdy, I know, but let's have a little play of that. I won't play through the whole thing, but we'll just to kind of get a vibe of the remix. Here we go. And it's not playing, is it? Because I soloed the a cappella. Let's give it a go again. Here we go. Great, so there we go. Quite a few elements going on there. General kind of feeling about the track. So I don't know if you're kind of familiar with the kind of work of Matthew Herbert around that time, Around the House, Bodily Functions. Just it's kind of got that really kind of, I don't know, deep kind of minimal sounds, kind of deep house sounds that I love. Very sort of sample heavy. We're going to look at that in a minute. I think very kind of resourceful as well with the sounds that he's using. I just to let you know, I don't know any. I'm just kind of imagining kind of like what might have been the process of putting this together. And I'm sure Matthew, if you're watching or you're going to watch back later, you can kind of shed some light on exactly what you use. But I mean, judging by the kind of quality of the vocal that's in this track, I'd imagine that he had stems, so the kind of vocal, full vocal a cappella. He might have had actually the whole multi-track, in which case he might have been able to sample kind of some of the other elements of it as well. Unfortunately, I haven't got that. I've just got the extracted a cappella. So, let's maybe kind of start off just by taking some of the sections of this and maybe kind of flipping them over into session view, just so that we can kind of just build. I'm not going to create the whole track, but just kind of some of the key sections. So it's Pixel Chaot. Okay, thank you. Thanks for the follow. Anyway, I just had something a window obscuring my chat. So it's a bit small. Anyway, cool. Let's just listen from the start again and just pick out some key sections. Oh, by the way, I have synced this up. So it came in at about 113 BPM. So if we just kind of, I just put the metronome on now. There we go. Okay, so let's just treat that as a section. And any section I'm going to copy over, I'll mark with a color. Let's just mark it as, seeing as it's Valentine's Day, pink. There we go. Okay, so that's just literally just some kind of keyboard riff, which we'll look at in a minute.
Edward Jesse James.
That's pretty much looping around.
Comment il vécu? Ça vous a plu, hein? Vous en demandez encore?
Okay, fading in a hi-hat, maybe.
Écoutez l'histoire de Bonnie.
Cool. So, let's mark that section. Then we've got the kick drum.
Alors voilà, Clyde a une petite amie.
Doing these in four bar chunks. There we go.
Une petite amie. Elle est belle et son prénom.
Nice sound coming in there. That. Smart that. Pretty much same thing. There we go. And then we've got bass line, killer bass line, with the kind of extra hi-hat as well. Let's mark that.
Moi lorsque j'ai connu Clyde.
Stays the same.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, here, some nice kind of pad coming in. Hey, Funky On, how you doing? Great to have you here. Big shout out. Okay, so here we've got a kind of like, sounds like quite an improvised little sample line that's being played. Let's just see how long that goes on for. Maybe I'll just take that this section here. Policeman se fait buter. This is really nice. Pour la police, ça ne fait pas de mystère. Not sure how far I'm going to get with this, but Bernie Parker, Bernie Hyde, Bernie and Clyde. Beautiful little riff there. So. Let's just mark this bit. Let's grab that. Okay, that's probably going to be enough. Yes, musician, thanks for the follow. Oh, subscribed, wow, fantastic, thanks so much. Much appreciated. Okay, just for the sake of consistency, let's grab this bit here. Another little nice synth line. Cool, I think that's going to be enough to be going on with. How should we do this? Let's use consolidate new time, consolidate time to new scene. I think that's probably the best way of doing it. I've got a key command for that, which is option command N, I believe. No, it's not. What is it? So shift command N. I always forget. Don't show again. Okay. There we go. Let's just check that's gone in. Cool. That's what we want. Nice. So I can just go through now and just do all these. And this should be putting them one after the other. Lovely. There we go. Yeah, so I changed the time. I've been doing this at 5 in the afternoon on a Sunday, kind of early evening, and it was all getting a bit hectic with trying to get Sunday roast together. So, not always Sunday roast. Thanks for sticking with the new time at 3. Here we go. Oh, there we go. I think that's all the parts. All right, so we've got this now. I'm going to say goodbye to this biscuit. Hey, I'm going to have a bite. Hope you don't mind. Except I've broken the heart. Oh no. Beautiful. It's actually the same colour as the clips. All right. Nice one. So here we go. I can trigger them from here now. And And what's great about the consolidating new scene is that it loops it for you.
Alors voilà, Clyde, Bonnie and Clyde.
There we go. All right, let's just start with the first thing, which is that kind of keyboard riff, the kind of ascending keyboard riff. So let's see how we can create that. I'm going to bring over one of my favorites, which is a preset. It sounds to me like it's an electric piano-esque type sound. I'll tell you what, I'll bring the VMPK up so you can kind of see what notes I'm playing. I haven't actually... Oh, there we go, it's working. Okay, so let's just have a listen to that again. So it sounds like... However, closer analysis... I don't know if that's like a kind of harmonic or an overtone or something. It sounds like it's... It's like really quiet in the background. Let's record that in. Well, actually, let's have another listen to it. Ah, so this could be... classic Matthew Herbert, where he's actually just sampled the one chord. And then I can hear some kind of out of time looping going on. So should we try doing that? Let's see if we see if just maybe if we just play in that. And then maybe that just really kind of quietly over the top. Cool. All right. So let's just mute that for the moment. And let's record this in. I will do it to the metronome and I will use quantize. Okay, so here we go. Okay, just bring this up. Now if I play maybe that really quietly over the top. Record it. Let's do it again. Okay. Just lose the metronome. Yeah, that kind of worked, I think. So let's just fold that and let's just bring those out like that. Okay, let's create another track and let's take the input as that face plant there. Let's make it, it doesn't really matter if it's pre or post, but let's make it pre-effects. Let's just check it's working. Taking the input, yep. All right, let's go. All right, that'll do. Let's just mute that now. Don't need that. And let's just play this. Cool. So we've got a nice audio file there. So let's now grab a sampler. And if I just drag that into there. There we go. That's nice. Okay, cool. Okay, so let's just get the start point. And yeah, let's set the loop. Let's put loop on and just at the end point. So let's just set the loop like that, the length as well. What do we want? So maybe take the quite nice. It's kind of almost I'm trying to sort of recreate how it might have been back in the day, not how it might have been, how it was, because I had an Akai S3000, so obviously we have no warp here, so the higher you play it, the kind of the faster the sample's playing, and also the faster the loop as well. Okay, I quite like that. So let's bring that down. Now let's have another quick listen to the original. And then we got... Okay, let's just move those out of the way for the moment because we don't need those now. All right, let's... it sounds to me like it's got some kind of chorus on it. So let's look at the... Live 11 options, and we've got this nice chorus ensemble now. It's kind of three plugins in one. We've got ensemble, vibrato as well, so classic chorus. I think that's pretty good. What I'm also going to do is just take the velocity down so the velocity is not affecting the amplitude, and I can bring up the volume to compensate for that. I think we need a bit of EQ on this as well, so let's just get a bit of EQ8. Maybe it's put it before the chorus, so a bit of cutoff. Listen again. Not bad. Let's maybe take a little bit of the bottom end off. Okay, cool. So let's record that in. Let's put the metronome back on again, and let's record that in. Nice. So what else have we got here? Let's take the metronome off again. Okay. Okay, I'm going to forget about the vocal for the moment, but there's that nice kind of sample coming in. So I wonder what that might be. Let's go back to the original now, and just have a listen. Turn it down. I wonder if it's actually sampled from part of that instrumental at the start. Maybe let's... What we could try doing is, let's just make those a bit smaller. Let's create another track. Actually, I'm also going to do a bit of housekeeping here. That's green, isn't it? So let's just do the chords. And let's create another track. And let's do another simpler. We're probably going to end up with lots of simplers here. But hey, we love simplers. There we go. Cool, and then let's drag that down there. Take this off here and expand this out. Maybe it's that. Let's try taking off some bottom end. Getting a bit closer at the start point there. Okay, let's just have a listen to the original again. Or not the original, the remix. That's better. Bitter, better. Maybe a bit more release. Good. Cool. So what comes in next?
Ça vous a plu, hein? Vous en demandez encore?
Okay, so.
Bien.
Hi-hat.
Écoutez l'histoire de. Ça vous a plu, hein?
Vous kind en of fading encore? In. Okay, so let's copy those down. So we've got the chords, we've got the. What should we call that? The. We call it a chang. The chords, the chang. Now we need a hat. So I suppose in the spirit of this as well, maybe we should try looking at extracting a hat from the original track as well. Hey, how about that? So maybe let's create another track. And again, let's get the sampler going. I could probably consolidate all this into a drum rack, to be honest, once we're done, but let's just work with this for the moment. Let's see if we can get a hat out of this as well. Let's go back here. Let's call this hats or hi-hats. And so there. So there's a nice kind of open hat there. If you can hear it. Let's see if we can isolate that. Cool, let's get the filter on again, take off some of that low end. There you go, you never know. And I have a funny feeling that he might be using that kind of later on as well, to kind of bring in like an extra hi-hat. Maybe that he's playing that up as well. And also using some different pitches of the hi-hat as well. Let's set some release on this. Okay, so pretty happy with that. So let's listen again to what he's doing.
Ça vous a plu, hein?
So.
Ça vous a plu, hein?
Maybe.
Ça vous a plu, hein? Vous en demandez encore? Bien. raconter l'histoire de... Ça vous a plu, hein? Ça vous a plu, hein? Vous en demandez encore? Eh bien, écoutez l'histoire de...
Let's try that. And then we can also look at the... Sounds to me like there's some swing on this as well, but I think it's quite random going all the way through the track, so I'm not going to sort of go into too much detail analysing every single hat, but it's definitely going some kind of like offbeats there. So let's record it in anyway and see how we get on. Let's put the metronome on. Come on. Okay, let's go again. Put it on the right track. Here we go. Play again. We need the hi-hats. There we go. Okay. What I'm going to do, as I did with the last one, I'm going to take the velocity off there. Bit of the low end as well, so I just want less of that pitch coming through. Okay, right, now we're going to get into some swing. And I'm going to use the same technique, actually, that I used last week, where... we can use some global swing. I could use the swing on push, but instead I'm going to just use the swing 16ths, 73. There we go. I'm going to put that on, and then that gives me a global swing setting here. You can see it's at 42 at the moment. That must have been when I was playing earlier on. So it's non-destructive, which is really good because it means that I can just put this across the whole track. So if I now just select all the other clips, it should apply that swing to all of them. There we go. And if I now play it. Okay.
Vous en demandez encore? Eh bien, écoutez l'histoire.
Okay, it could have been I can still hear there's a bit of music underneath that hi-hat, so Matthew might have had lucky enough to have the stems just as the drums, and that would have not had it then, but hey, maybe there's another section, another bit later down the track where it's a bit more isolated, that hi-hat. But let's move on to the next clip now.
Bonnie and Clyde.
Cool, so we've got the kick. So I'm going to have a very quick listen through to the original to see if there's any kick I maybe isolated that we can grab from here. I suspect not, in which case we'll just use a kick drum.
Comment il vécu?
I mean, I can't even hear a kick anyway.
Écoutez l'histoire de Bonnie and Clyde.
Hey, Funky on, yeah, I know the global swing is killer. I've used it so much. I still really am slightly bemused about the correlation between the swing that you can set on here, the swing amount, how that correlates to the swing actually when you're working on the computer in the door. I need to sort of just look into that more. Any Ableton nerds watching, let me know how that kind of correlates. So I tend to kind of, maybe if I'm doing a live thing and I just want something quickly, I'll use the quantize on here. But it would be nice to have some sort of global swing actually on push as well, and you know, that works in a similar way. Yeah, funky on. Yeah, it's not related. It's a real shame actually. But look, I'm gonna forget the kick from here, and I'm just going to use a kick, and I'm going to go use one that I always tend to come back to, which is the drum synth, which are now up here in Live 11. And by the way, I don't know if anyone's seen that we've got there's a release date now, February 23rd, for Live 11 proper, which is really exciting. And yeah, I definitely want to do, you know, a kind of run through of sort of all the features again on one of these streams, just after it's been officially released. So cool. Let's drag this kick over here, and let's take solo off. Cool. Let's put the accent on. Right. So it's pretty manipulable. Manipulable, is that a word? You can manipulate this pretty well. And if we can maybe try and get something that's close. So,
Bonnie and Clyde.
So a lot of bottom end on there, but pitch wise, maybe you can add some click.
Bonnie and Clyde.
Maybe slightly less decay. It's very, very short, isn't it? Nice. Okay, so let's copy these parts down.
Bonnie and Clyde.
Okay, let's listen to the pattern before we put it in.
Bonnie and Clyde. Alors voilà, Clyde.
So,
Bonnie and Clyde.
That's it. Here we go. Cool. Are we all good here? Yes, we are. Okay. Okay. So let's do the same thing. Let's add the swing to that. Nice. Not totally convinced with the chords that in the way that I sampled it. It sounds a little not quite as smooth musically as in the original Herbert remix. But hey, let's work with it for the moment. Okay, let's listen to the next clip now.
Une petite amie. Elle est belle, et son
so we've got this sound now. Bam, bam.
Une petite amie.
Now, it wouldn't surprise me if that is a sample as well, but I'm going to try a different approach to this. I'm going to try maybe creating some kind of synth sound that approximates that. So let's just go to kind of where I always tend to go, which is the Tau Uno LX. And before I even play anything, let's turn it down because it's always really loud. And let's just see what we could start off with potentially. Almost Dark Roads. It's actually quite nice for the, but no. Okay, so not the Dark Roads. What else have we got? Got synth. Piano. I'm just kind of going by memory here. You certainly don't want any of that. octave up string. All right, that's kind of getting there. Let's listen to the original again. And let's put this soloed as well. Une petite amie. Elle est belle. Bad. surprising. Okay, let's put a bit of reverb on, because it does sound like it's got a bit of reverb. Okay, so just check where it comes. Elle est belle et son prénom c'est Bonnie. Une petite amie, une petite amie. Slightly different rhythm. Elle est belle et son prénom c'est Bonnie. Une petite amie. Une... So, let's record it in playing along to the original. Une petite amie. Elle est belle et son prénom c'est Bonnie. Une petite amie. Une petite amie. Elle est belle et son prénom c'est Bonnie. Swing on it. Comes slightly before. Une petite amie. Elle est belle et son prénom c'est Bonnie. Une petite amie. Nice. Okay, let's. What have we got next? Oh, by the way, I think I should just have a little break here. Hey, Moda, just reading out your message here. Oh, thank you very much, man. That's very, what a kind message. It's great. Well, it's just brilliant to have everyone along. This is something that I'm really just sort of doing as a bit of a hobby, really, but really, really enjoying it. At the start of the year, I knew absolutely nothing about how Twitch worked at all, and I've just been picking it up as I've been going along. And it's a really nice way just to do something really spontaneously and try to, yeah, my kind of aim is just to build a bit of a community, and we can all kind of be looking at things together, making suggestions, learning along the way, because we're all learning, aren't we, all the time. But yeah, thank you so much, and thanks everyone for joining in. It really is absolutely brilliant. Cool, so let's just listen to the next section now. Oh no, what I was going to show you something, wasn't I? This is actually a brilliant picture. It's kind of slightly elusive as well, because you can't see exactly what's going on. but yeah, this is Matthew Herbert, I think around the time, whether he did this remix in this studio, it's his Swing Time studio. I don't know, but yeah. And it's a picture there of the late pianist Phil Parnell, who very sadly passed away. Incredible pianist. He'd played a lot of the keyboard parts with Matthew Herbert. But yeah, it's a great, great insight there. So yeah, please follow Matthew Herbert on Instagram to check out more great pics like that. Cool. So let's listen to the next section now. All right. So it's my favourite bit. It's the bass. Cool. All right, so let's create another MIDI track, and probably I'm going to be a bit lazy and go for another sound that I've just been using for years. It's this Chicago tight bass, which I created. And I always kind of start from this point, and it's the first thing I often do as a bass sound. You see, it's like polyphonic, so it's like really distorted and horrible. So the first thing I do is just make it monophonic. There we go. All right. And let's just take the release off a bit. It sounds, I don't know, not exactly the same as the original. Let's have a listen to the original again. So this is a bit more muted, isn't it? Let's bring up the keyboard as well so we can see what we're doing. Well, haven't even discussed what key signature we're in yet, which is a bit weird. All right, something like that. Anyway, this sounds like it's a bit too resonant, this. Okay, that sounds about right. So the notes are... What happens the next time around? That's it. Okay, let's try playing that in. Okay, let's record it in. Go again. Delete. So just remind myself. Okay. There we go. Hey, I just got something there. Well, I've missed it as well. Whatever it was, thank you. It was a follow from Busy Till. Thank you so much for the follow. Really appreciate that. Okay. Nice. Yeah, pretty happy with that. Let's do the swing. Ah, there's another hi-hat coming in here. So that's the original. Cool. Now I'm going to, because we've got this other hi-hat, I'm actually going to duplicate that part, that track. So we've got this here. Sorry, I've got another keyboard here that you can't see that I'm playing. I'm gonna keep remember to play this one here. So let's just have a listen to see what. There's more, sounds like there's more kind of hi-hat action, lower hi-hat action, but then you've got this. For a start, it's louder. Maybe put some. Let's try some EQ actually on this. Let's take that resonance off. let's get the EQ, channel EQ on here. Not the channel EQ. EQ 8. I'm almost sort of playing a few of these together. Also sounds like it's kind of shorter. No, maybe not. Thank you. pretty simple. Let's record that in. And I'm going to re-look at this hi-hat now, the original, and let's see if we can... So it's da-da, da-da, da-da-da. Kind of, it's pretty crazy, isn't it? Let's try something out, anyway. Put the swing on it. Okay. I'm just going to change the start point of that hi-hat. Balancing. Okay, so let's just have a little playthrough now to see where we're at. Definitely getting there. Time for a little sip of water, I think. How's everyone doing? Hope you're all well on a Sunday. Maybe that might help if I can open that. Yeah, as I said earlier, please keep the suggestions going. I'm making a spreadsheet now, so I'm going to put in all the suggestions. I've already got about 6 or 7 that are coming in. They're kind of coming in all different directions, you know, some on Twitter, some on Instagram, some on Discord now. But keep them coming in and I get through them, you know. I really want to see if I can keep this going through the whole year. One I had planned actually was a Japanese vinyl sampling session. So I was going to do today, but I'll probably do next week, where I just want to go through, maybe take 10 random samples, just put them together and see what we can make. That could be quite fun. Cool. So let's keep going. Let's see what's happens in the next clip. Okay. Really beautiful string section. It's getting a bit crowded here, so... going to give ourselves a bit more space. Cool, so let's see if we can figure this out. I've got another favorite here that I always use, which is called Weeping Strings. Let's just... very bright. Let's take the cutoff down. Sounds something like that. Play it again. Let's listen to what it sounds like over all that. Hey Moda, so project files. Yeah, I mean, I suppose I just, you have to make sure that I can get the permission basically, but I think this is probably fine because this is not the original parts, this is just me, my transcription. So, but yeah, I think let's that's a really good idea. Let me look at that and I'll get back to you because I think that could be a great idea. Cool, so let's just put something in. It doesn't have to be exactly the same. Nice. Cool. So let's just put the swing back on that as well. Right, we're moving ahead. How many have we got? Four more clips to go. Let's just see what comes next. C'est pas drôle. Whoa. C'est pas drôle. C'est pas drôle. C'est pas drôle. C'est pas drôle. Okay, first of all, let's strip it down to what we've got in the background. C'est pas drôle. C'est pas drôle. Okay, so we've just got that kind of high hi-hat. We've got the kick. We've got the bass. Actually, that's not the bass, is it? C'est pas drôle. 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 Yeah, I wonder if that sample is made out of the kind of chang sound that we had here, which is this one. What I'm going to do is duplicate that, drag it over here, get rid of these other parts, and then we can actually kind of edit that separately because it's definitely got a a loop on it. Let's play this. It's probably not, to be honest. It does sound like it's the right chord though. Let's make it really short. Let's put the loop on. Let's take the snap off. It just sounds so like it could be. What I might do is actually just put the part in using that anyway. Let's put it in anyway. Okay, here we go. So, what do we got here? We got. That's as far as I'm going to go with that one. Did that sound? Yeah, maybe a bit of Redux. That could be good. Let's try it out. Thanks, Funkion. You never know. Yeah, not bad. I think as well, it's definitely, a bit donks. Hey Ravine, Stanley, how you doing? Donks, each and every time, we need the donks. All right, let's have... Matthew, if you're watching, I'm sorry, man. Actually, I've got this kind of really old Casio, really kind of crappy Casio keyboard. It's, I'm sure there's a similar sort of sound on that, quite kind of FME sound. And I was just actually that kind of post I was showing you earlier. Matthew actually did a sort of little test to see if anyone could tell what the keyboards were. And one of them is actually a CZ-101, Casio CZ-101, or a CZ-1000, I'm not sure. So it could be something from that, I'm not sure, or just a sample of something completely different. Who knows? Anyway. Let's put the... It's got the grooves on it already. It's cool. So where are we now? Let's have a listen to this now. Okay. Okay, so what have we got here? We've got the strings. I think maybe slightly different. Is it that? I'm going to put that in anyway. Okay. And then we've got this sound, which is not the bass, it's this. Let's try that. Right, we've got that, and then we've just got a little kind of little nice little synthy sound. Let's see if we can do something with that. Let's see what we've got here. I'm just wondering if there's anything I can go on here that might be a good starting point. What's this? Larry 101. That's going to be a bass sound, isn't it? I just need like a little kind of blippy sound. Let's just have a listen to this Eric bass. Could be a starting point. It's not bad. Put that in. It's close enough. Let's just see what happens next. I think that's when everything comes back in, isn't it? Cool. So let's copy all these over. We got the bass, we got the strings, we got the hats, we got the low chords. I'm not happy with that little sound. Forgot the kick. Okay, nice. I'm just going to do a little bit of mixing here because the kick is just getting totally drowned out. So I'm just selecting everything but the kick. There we go, just bring it down. Quite nice anyway, actually. nice. All a bit quiet now. Let's put a limiter on it. Too loud now. Cool. I think there is one more part, but I think I'm going to move on and just maybe try out some of the lyrics or the vocals. One thing I haven't done is talk about the key signature. So let's just put this on now. What we're actually in is G minor, which is quite weird because the bass is playing these fifths. And the bass line as well is copying that going. Actually, the tonic is G. Carried away, sorry. Okay. That'd probably be better off just with the sort of normal sound, wouldn't it? Okay, so where are we at then? Let's just look at find the a cappella here, which is
Vous avez lu l'histoire de Jesse James? Comment il a vécu? Comment il est mort? Ça vous a plu?
So let's see if we can get this, just put this into a sampler. It's not great, but it will do. And then at least we've got that. And we can use that as a part of the rhythm, to build up the rhythm. So let's just create one more part. Get the instruments and our old favorite, the simpler. Here we go. Drag that into there. Sound like Joe Wicks with all his recipes. Stick it in there. Bit of pepper, bit of onion. Okay. So let's go from where does that sample first come in? Yeah, there. Let's just play along to here. But up. see what it sounds like without it. Bit random. That'll do. Does it come in again? Let's just copy it down. There's a little feature. Why do I keep doing that? Stop it. Cool. So let's just have a little listen to this with the track, as I was about to do earlier. And then I think we're there. I think we've had a bit of fun. So that would be the next stage, really, is just to start sort of syncing up the... vocal. There we go. So hope you enjoyed that. I definitely enjoyed it. I didn't know where that was going to go, how successful I was going to be with putting it together. Matthew, I'd love to know, get a bit more insight into your approach. Modo, yeah, thank you very much. I was just, really kind of just trying to sort of imagine what he might have done. And I'm sure there's some other really kind of cool techniques and things that he would have used at the time, but this was 2001, so there wasn't, you know, he probably wasn't using Ableton at the time. Maybe he was, but he was probably using just sort of hardware stuff. The Vulture UK, thanks so much. Pixie Chaos, thank you so much as well. Great to have you here. I'm going to do something during the week, I'm not sure what yet, but either an ambient thing or something else. But thanks everyone for checking in, and enjoy the rest of your Sunday. Eat some nice food and enjoy it with your loved ones. And thank you very much. See you later on. Bye.